Good evening, everyone, and Merry Christmas. I would like to explain the change of venue here. If you haven't been upstairs, it is very cold up there in the sanctuary. The heat pumps just can't keep up with the sub-zero temperatures. So we're down here where we have good old-fashioned hot water heat, and we're nice and comfortable. So we're going to celebrate our Christmas Eve service down here and our Christmas morning service tomorrow as well, because it's not going to warm up very much tomorrow morning. So we're going to plan to be here as well. We are going to have our regular candlelight and communion service for Christmas Eve this evening. The communions that you have are little tear-off things. You tear off the top layer to get to the wafer, then you tear off the second layer to get to the juice. And I'll go through that again when we get there. And we also have the candlelight service, and I'll light a candle from the altar, and then we'll share that light amongst us. And when we get to the offering, I'll pass the plates around, and we can take the offering that way. If you have any questions, please just stop me and ask. At this time, I'd like to offer the invocation before our prelude. We gather on this holy night to worship Almighty God in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Winter in Bethlehem is chilly, but with frost in the desert and snow on Mount Carmel. And worse still, there was the cold power of the Romans holding down people with heavy taxes and swashbuckling swords. Jesus was born in a dangerous world filled with disease and early death, filled with riots and crucifixion. But he came with good news. God cares about people in rough times. God has hope for the world. Tonight we care, celebrating the good news, so that we sing till sundown. Hum your joy, dress in starlight, girls and boys. Man and woman climb the hill, warmed by December's chill. Reeling, clapping, touch the air. Is that fragrant music there? Come with glory gone the gloom in a wondrous huddled room. Christ the Word we long to know calls us dancing through the snow. Gladness deepens in your grace, weaves its light on every face. Let us wake the sleeping earth, celebrate the sweetest birth. Pierce the night with festive cry, bloom in colors of the sky. Bring the flute and the tambourine, wave the branch of evergreen. Lost we were a brief ago, now we're dancing through the snow. I invite all who are able to rise for our processional hymn, O Come All You Faithful. You can follow in the green books of the book on that. Rests upon his shoulder, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, his authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This night these words are fulfilled in our hearing and in our living, for the promise of God has come to us. Our lives are the manger in whom the Christ child is born. No longer do we seek light from another source. Now the light burns in our hearts and we become love's lamp. So we light the candle at the center of our wreath and our faith. We light it in the name of the one who is the light, as Mary did so long ago. We name this light Jesus. For now, we relight the candles of hope and peace. And joy. And for the moment, we will hold the Christ candle until we celebrate that night together. And by all we're able to, please rise for our Advent hymn, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, verses 1 and 4. Friends, hear the good news. The Lord has come and is coming again.
Let the peace of God be guarded over our hearts and our lives in Christ Jesus.
Friends, believe the good news.
In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven.
Thank you.
first registration was taken while Cornelius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Oh,
are shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone all around them. They were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. I ask you to remain seated for our next parable, First Noel, verses 1 and 4. Help us to use all of our gifts properly as we fulfill this mission. We ask all of these things in Christ's name. Amen. This time I want to invite all who are willing to join me in our Holy Communion. Does anyone need one of their cups? Everyone have one? And before we begin, I tell you, just open that top part to get the wafer. It will be a little tricky. You're welcome to follow along on the monitor or on the insert in the table. Beloved in Christ, the gospel tells us that on the first day of the week, Jesus Christ was raised from death, appeared to Mary Magdalene, and on that same day sat at the table with two disciples and was made known to them in the breaking of bread.
This is the glorious feast of the people of God.
Men and women, youth and children, come from the east and the west, from the north and the south, and gather about Christ's table.
This table is for all Christians who wish to know the presence of Christ and to share in the community of God's people. God be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to God.
Let us give thanks to God Most High.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
We give you thanks, Holy One. Almighty and eternal God, always and everywhere, through Jesus Christ, the only one begotten by you before all time, by whom you made the world and all things, we give you thanks for the gift of Jesus, our only Savior, who is the way, the truth, and the life. Amen. From the night of betrayal, Jesus took bread, and after giving thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, also after supper, Jesus took the cup, and after giving you thanks, gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Gracious God, accept with favor this our sacrifice of praise, which we now present with these holy gifts. We offer to you ourselves, giving you thanks for the perfect offering of the only one begotten by you, Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. Come, for all things are ready. This bread is to us as the body of our Savior Jesus Christ, broken for you and me, broken to repair the bond between us and our Creator. Take and eat in remembrance. This cup is to us as the blood of our Savior Jesus Christ, shed for the sins of the many, shed for you and me. Take and drink in remembrance of him. Please join in our prayer of thanks. Bountiful God, we give you thanks that you have refreshed us at your table by granting us the presence of Christ. Strengthen our faith, increase our love for one another, and send us forth into the world in courage and peace, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Before we continue with the sharing of the light, I'd like to offer a few thanks tonight. Certainly a thanks to our choir and our accompanist, choir director, organist, you name it, in charge of all the music, for adapting so quickly and so effortlessly to a new situation. Really appreciate that. And I would like everyone to thank our choir and our accompanist for the music they have provided us this evening. And now, we'll begin to share the light of Christ together. I'll take the light from the altar. We will pass it along to one another. And then we will join our voices together in singing Silent Night. I ask all who are able to please rise. Let us now share the light of Christ with one another and lift our voices to heaven. We will sing Silent Night, and on the third verse, we will lift the light of the candle of Christ as a beacon to a world in darkness and in pain. Thank you.
My daughter was singing, so we
This is my
Do you have your candles? I'll take them in your cups if you still have them.
Thank you.
Here you have them. I'll take your cups too if you still have them. Tell him I said hello and Merry Christmas. Come on, that's Alec too.
Oh, yeah. 21st is coming up.
Same. Okay. I got it. I'll see you later.
Merry Christmas.
I can't hear people.
No, this beeps.
I can't hear them.
Merry Christmas.
Are we supposed to put these somewhere?
Pastor Steve.
Merry Christmas.
Real smile. Merry Christmas.
Tell Chris and the boys we said hello.
Sure.
Pass that all along.
You ready?
Yep.
Got everything?
Mirrors on my rental. car wouldn't open. They were frozen. So I had to sit and let the car warm up before the mirrors would slowly creak open. I didn't want to push it.
This is my first winter. Like, why did you
get yeah.
The Subaru used to like.
Oh,
yeah.